He may have played it very cagey. Yeah, you don't bet the house on it. So, it's time to go Omnium. Should we have an eliminator, Joe?
Yes, let's. Another one. Mm. Our fourth one in 3 days.
Gosh, yes, we're elimination heavy, aren't we?
We are.
Welcome back. Matt Walls starts the third phase of the men's Omnium at the rail. And he leads after winning the tempo race earlier on. He did a great job in the scratch as well. Came home in third place. Who's he going to face? Well, Karaliok leads off at the blue line. And so this is how it stacks up overall. Walls versus Karaliok at the moment. And they have a little bit of headroom ahead of Yuri Leitão of Portugal. But Leitão, of course, is already a European champion from the scratch race, which he absolutely dominated, Joe.
He did. He had a fantastic ride there, gaining a lap on his own and then attacking the group again to solo to the win. So, yeah, Leitão of Portugal looking supremely strong. He also took silver in the elimination race on day one of competition, which was, of course, won by the British rider, Matt Walls, who is leading this competition now. So we should be in for a real treat here.
I think so. Love a bit of an eliminator. It's often referred to as the devil as well, from the rather long title, Devil Take the Hindmost, Joe.
Yes, I've always known it as a devil, actually. I've always called it a devil until it became an Olympic event as part of the Omnium, and it's been sort of named the elimination race officially, but in my head it's the devil. But no, I've had to correct myself on that one, call it the elimination race, but you're bringing me back to old habits.
Yeah, I like the old title, I must admit, but because quite frankly, it is quite hellish, especially if you get trimmed off at the back. Let's hope that that is not a fate that befalls Matt Walls, who is a European elimination champion. So he should thrive here. However, strange things can happen when it comes to the Omnium and particularly the elimination. We've seen in the women's eliminator earlier, the leader, Maria Martins, finishing sixth after a big error. And the Russian Federation, Novolodskaya, who's only 2 points behind the leader, even worse, she finished 10th in that. It's no respecter of prowess, this one. You can make an error at any time, get yourself locked in, because it depends not how you're riding necessarily, but how everyone's riding around you, Joe.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And, you know, if you get boxed in, sometimes you've got the legs, but you can't use them. And that is, of course, extremely frustrating. And it is very much a combination of skill as well as the physical ability on the bike. It's always a race that's run off really fast. So, you know, you need to have your big gear on ready. You need to be attentive and, you know, warmed up well, ready to go from the off. But you're right. It's about being in those right positions as well. And, you know, sort of ducking and diving and squeezing through those gaps where necessary.
Away they go. And this will be a bit cagey. They will circulate until the referees are pleased enough. Then the gun will go. And then we'll start circulating and waiting for the bell to announce. Everyone happy? Not quite up to speed just yet. Yeah, you don't want anyone divorced just for now. So they'll wait for the pack to come round. Gosh, looking like a swarm of hornets. It's appealing to the referee, who fires the gun. A thud of a pigeon in the infield, and away we go. So, wait for the bell. It should come this time by. And then it is the sprint next time. So every other lap from now on in, somebody's going to lose out. Who's going to be first? Well, at the moment, Switzerland are playing with fire at the bottom of the track. In fact, it's not Switzerland. Let's have a look. Oh, Italy are in trouble. A little bit of shoulder edge. Let's see. And I think that, there we go. Who's going to get declared for this one? I think it may well be a decision. Rider eliminated. Krista, there we are, of Romania. Well, shoulders not permitted, Joe.
No, and he was in seventh place overall, so having a good event so far. Seventh in the scratch and sixth in the tempo, but first out, 19th place in this elimination race.
Yep, you can't start getting physical. Referees will be all over you. Meanwhile, Oh, not good for Slovenia. There we are at the bottom, and that is German has gone. So finishes this one 18th. He was down towards the bottom of the Omnium rack anyway, in 18th position. Volikakis did not start, by the way, the tempo race, so don't look for Christos, the Greek. Meanwhile, they continue to ply their trade, and there's a few in a shaky position here, a few locked in where they won't want to be. Gosh, well, we're already seeing a few shaky ones. Kubis has gone, Joe.
Yeah, Slovakian rider there, I think, realised it was his time and just a little shake of the head and accepting that that was his fate there.
Well, it seems that we are trimming off some very, very early riders here. Austria looked to be in trouble. Müller got nowhere to go unless he's got some rush room at the bottom. He finds a little bit, which puts the pressure on Portugal. And I think they've gone. Late out, disaster, Joe.
Third place overall, and now out fourth in the Devils. This is there. Not a good event for him at all.
Desperate. Finishes 16th in this, and that could end his hopes of an Omnium title. Shows you just how it could crumble for you. Very much so. Hungary playing with fire here, and it looks like a give up, I'm afraid, at the back, unless he can get up very, very late. No is the answer. So Hungary, Lovaski it is that goes next. Gosh, what a shock for Leitao. We said there could be some upsets, and that's a huge one, Joe. Here's the bell. Next time by, somebody else is going to go.
Yeah, that is a huge upset to have the third place overall rider to go out ever so early in this elimination race. So we'll be all changing the overall standings for him now.
Ukraine in trouble, being held down towards the line, but it's Bulgaria, I think. It is. Bulgaria is that Janov, I'm afraid, finishing in 14th place. Gosh, I'm still reeling after Leitao, who we're expecting to go so well. It's not going to happen for him. That's too much ground to make up when we get to the points race a little bit later. Bell's gone, sprint lap, they come high, wide and handsome. But some rush room down at the bottom, and this could be a catch out for some, but Austria, I think, are going to go. Müller takes the walk.
Yeah, Müller was in 10th place overall coming into this, so not a great event for him, but sort of still around the middle of the field he's come out here.
Ukraine are playing with fire at the bottom of the track. I know that the bell's gone, there's still a lap to unwind, but when you're tucked in and you've got riders holding you down there, there's not really much wiggle room, I'm afraid. And I think the Ukraine in the blue and yellow here are now still locked in. Look at that, riders just timing this beautifully. And that was telegraphed from a lap out, Joe.
Yeah, it was, and I think he realised it at that point as well. He knew there was nowhere to go for him, and even if he had the legs, he couldn't get out of that situation. So, yeah, Ukraine out.
Yeah, when you're held like that and somebody's on your quarters, there's no way for you to dab the brakes, come round and then have to power on, because you just run out of track. And Lithuania are in trouble now, bottom of the track. Oh, Italy, suddenly, Greece, I beg your pardon, let's have a look, but it is Lithuania. Goodness me, nowhere to roll. Benesis. Well, we warned them, Joe.
Ah.
You've got to be so careful. So, Belarus still functioning, don't forget. Karaliok is second to Matt Walls, who we haven't mentioned. That's because he's in such a good position. But Belarus have been dicing with doom here. Now, there's a couple of run rooms, one down below, but Italy look to be struggling right now. Get away with it. Israel, it is the go, I'm afraid. I think Einhorn, yes, it is. Finishing this one in 10th place. Out of the 19. Well, who's your money on? It's I'm hoping that Matt Walls doesn't make any mistakes. He's put a lot of effort into this, which shows he must be in really great form. Torres as well is determined, and that's the Swiss rider, I think, that just got boxed in at the bottom. Yeah, the camera's looking at the Italian, but it was Switzerland at the bottom, Claudio Imhoff. That's a surprise. It's also a surprise how badly he's going in this. Form is a bit strange this year, Joe.
Form is fickle at the best of times, and I think even more so when we're in the midst of a pandemic and all the changes that have happened globally these days. So yeah, no, interesting to see how riders are racing this event, because it is a completely untraditional run-in.
I think that's a blue towel that's being thrown here by Italy. I think they've just about had enough. So Italy will be next to go. Moro. Moro running in ninth place, so it's fitting that he finishes this one in eighth. Belarus just chinked underneath Poland here. Suggestion of a shoulder. Big pickup. Poland looked like there's something missing, and yet again, we're kind of seeing, oh, does find something, digs deep, but this is trouble, I'm afraid. For those still functioning, the Czech Republic in a really nasty position. There's a wall of riders and nowhere to go. Well, they tried to throw the bike, but nowhere for Rugovic. This is great racing, Joe.
It is. He had nowhere to go there, so I think we could see he was it was tight. And I'm looking at Matt Walls as the first one I've really spoken about him, because he's been in good positions throughout, but now we're just down to this final five now, and he should just be wary that there's not many people behind him anymore.
18 started today after Volikakis unfortunately had to withdraw this evening, I should say. Torres finally says, okay, I'll see you later, and we will see an awful lot of Torres as well. So he finishes in fifth place. Matt Walls, we've barely mentioned his name because he's been riding so brilliantly, and Belarus's Karaliok is at the back here, so he's scanning everything that's going on in front of us. Rostovtsev, the Russian, equally nicely placed. Poland in the mix here as well, and Staniszewski is going to go. Finishes fourth, though.
Yeah, great ride there by the Polish rider. He was in eighth place coming into this, so would have improved himself in the overall rankings of this Omnium.
Yeah, very much so. I think he's going to be top five going into the points race. How much effort he'll have left or power, we'll shall wait and see, but this is the cream of the crop you've got right now. Matt Walls, what can he do? Can he make this turn into a sprint off a little bit later on? And Belarus has said, okay, guys, have it. So Russia versus GB, third place for Karaliok. The points start to narrow in terms of their difference at this point. So he takes 36 points. There's 38 points for whoever gets trimmed off next, but it's going to turn up into a two-upper. Matt Walls won the tempo. He'll want to win this one as well. He's up against the Russian, Rostovtsev. Either way, Matt Walls will lead going into the points race because of the difference between them. Rostovtsev starting off today six in this one. And Walls lets him have it. Second place with 38 points for Matt Walls puts him on a very handsome tally. And Rostovtsev with the 40 pulls himself back up into fourth place, I think, overall. That's good work by both of those two riders, Joe.
It is good work. So with Karaliok of Belarus taking third place there, Matt Walls pulls out an extra two-point lead over him on the overall, conceding there, taking second place, accepting that he didn't need to battle for that win. Of course, we've got a points race coming up very soon this evening, so there's a lot of tired legs out there, so Matt Walls taking a sort of sensible decision there when it came to that final sprint.
And a reminder, Joe, that whatever tally you have now, you can add to through the reach of the points race.
You can. So we start the points race with whatever the rider's subtotal is for the Omnium overall up till this point. So I haven't actually calculated the actual points, but whatever they come in with, that will be their starting tally. And then as we progress throughout the points race, they'll add to that tally, whether they win sprints with 5, 3, 2, and 1, or gain a lap and get 20 points. And then we'll end up with the overall standings and the total points.
Well, by my rudimentary maths, congratulations to Rostovtsev, then, and commiserations for Yuri Leitao finishing 15th. That really was a disastrous moment. 114 points by my rudimentaries. And there we are, 4 points clear of Karaliok, Torres of Spain. And look what happened to Leitao. level on points at the top, and all of a sudden in eighth, and with an enormous gap to make up of 34 points. That's a nightmare, Joe.
Yeah, but a lot could happen in this points race, and I think if you're a few more positions down, you're not, you know, quite on the radar of the leaders ever so much, and perhaps you might be able to sneak away. I say sneak away, this is of course a European champion we're talking about here, Yuri Leitão of Portugal, but he did slip away nicely in that scratch.